Hey guys, this is Irie Starcraft, and I'm back to cast another game for you. This one will be a 3v3, and it will be on Monsoon. And it's going to be between Blue Meanie, the Red Zerg, that's not going to confuse me or anything, and Blue Zerg will be Killaman. The Blue Zerg will be Killaman, I should say, and Rain Man will be the Teal Zerg, so Triple Zerg on the bottom. The top team will be Earthmaster, the purple Protoss, and Ice, the orange Zerg, and Chronic Gaiman, the yellow Zerg. So players on the top team are member of Team Gosu, the 4v4 team that won the Zeke.com tournament a couple weeks ago that I was casting. Extremely exciting games in that tournament. Which reminds me, I'm looking forward to the 4v4 tournament on Wednesday. I will be casting it live on my channel, if all goes according to my plan, my evil plan, which is to not have me doing something this Wednesday night, which I have been busy the last few, so sorry about that. But anyway, let's get to the game, man. It's Monsoon, man. This map can provide some pretty exciting games, though oftentimes it provides some crappy games, so we'll be... it'll be interesting to see how this turns out. Let's check out what the Zergs are doing first. It looks like Killaman, Tenpool, Blue Meanie, Tenpool, and Ice, Chronic Gaiman, all Tenpool. So, what do we got down here? Tenpool. Maybe even sooner than Tenpool? Nah, that's a Tenpool. And so lots of Zerglings on the way for the bottom team. Meanwhile, Earthmaster appears to be building a forge in his main here and going to be putting a cannon inside his mineral line. So nobody's going to be bothering trying to wall off. And that's a good decision here. See, the thing is, it can be effective to wall off here, but only if you have no Zergs on your team. If you have a Zerg on your team, it totally screws up walling off on this map because the opponents will be able to get in the Zerg base and then run around the back because there's these ramps in the back that lead to the expansions that also connect between the bases. So, something to think about there. If there's a Zerg on your team, no sense in trying to wall off the front in general, as Zerglings will be meeting in the middle here. No, these are all from the bottom team. Who am I? But Ice is scouting that with his Overlord, so a large group of Zerglings coming into Ice's base here, and he appears to have gone straight for a Baneling's Nest, but that may turn out to be some pretty bad luck on his part because there are a bunch of Zerglings inside his main, and Ice is going to be doing all he can to try and stay alive here. I don't see any Zerglings coming over from Chronic Gaiman. It looks like Chronic Gaiman is going to be playing defensively. Ice maybe totally screwing this game. Here's Chronic Gaiman and Zerglings trying to trap some of them back here behind the mineral line. And Ice is trying to morbid some Banelings, and they could blow up here. He needs to blow them up just to stay alive in this game. He's used up all of the Banelings. And now there are still 5 Zerglings back here for Killaman. Chronic Gaiman does not have speed yet on his Zerglings. It is only halfway done, and Ice's drones are getting chased down. And Earthmaster, with his cannon opening here, is not going to be able to help his teammates. And so surprising that the bottom team's Zerglings, that they did not try the Protoss base, but you never know. I mean, when it's about timing at this point, you just go into whoever's base. Just go for it, man. Because they didn't even bother sending a drone scout or anything. But Chronic Gaiman, it looks like is trying to keep Ice in this game, and for now Ice's base is still alive and he has 5 drones, and Chronic Gaiman does have a spine crawler here, so for now they are okay. More Zerglings are streaming up, and Rayman may just be checking out what is up with Earthmaster's base here, and cannons will make that pecking not happen, not work, I should say. Chronic Gaiman with a ton of Zerglings now. Gonna be able to clean up Rayman's stuff. And I'm curious to see where Earthmaster goes from here. 2 gateways forged, and he is going to be throwing down a Twilight Council, so we could possibly see some DTs. Maybe we will go straight to Blinkstalkers, but that could depend on how his teammates fare here, because Blinkstalker is not gonna be very effective against the Triple Zerg team unless his teammates can cover him with some Zerglings of their own. And now a lot of roaches on the way for Blue Meanie, and that is going to prove extremely powerful. Chronic Gaiman will not be able to take on this army all by himself. It looks like that is what he's going to be forced to do. He's going to be taking on two players worth of Zerglings, but if he can fight in his base, he should be okay. Blue Meanie, though, has sent five roaches up into Icy's base, who's been desperately trying to rebuild some drones. And now Killaman and Rayman are going to bring their Zerglings up to support. It looks like Ice is probably going to lose this hatchery. Chronic Gaiman could engage the smaller ball of Zerglings while this hatchery is being attacked, but it does not look like he's going to do that. Chronic Gaiman is going to go for a counterattack, and I don't know if this is the best idea right now for Chronic Gaiman. He is going to be able to pick off some reinforcing roaches, but his base is going to be extremely vulnerable, and it doesn't look like he has decided where to attack yet. I'm not sure where would be the best place. Apparently, Teal down here, Rain Man, I think that just got scouted by some by a Zergling or something, has revealed that his base is pretty weak. So Chronic Gaiman will be going right after Rain Man's base and going to be trying to kill as many drones as he possibly can here. I'm worried that I'm missing something at the top. At the same time, it looks like Zerglings have streamed into Chronic Gaiman's base and his Spinecrawler has gone down. So while those Zerglings were chilling up here, what was happening was Chronic Gaiman was trying to defend his base, and now he's in a lot of trouble because he has just got all he's got left running around down here. And it doesn't look like... Did he kill? He did kill quite a few drones. So he put Rain Man on the back burner, so to speak, here. And now it is basically... It is basically a one-on-three now for Earthmaster. But he does have Dark Templars being warped in right now and warping them in on the low ground here. Interesting. He may warp in one more up on this high ground. And I need to work on my DT timing, so I want to check this out. As it looks like he's going to be okay in the main base. He's sending both Dark Templars into Blue Meanie's mineral line, who does have a lair finished. But I don't even see any overlords around his base, so he may not even be able to get out an overseer in time here if he can't. If the lair is now being killed and there's no overseer being warped in. There's the overseer for Blue Meanie. And are there any more DTs? I don't know. There's only these two DTs, and they are going to be able to kill this lair. It looks like it may actually be very close. The Spinecrawler now is able to see the DTs, so the DTs running away, and the Overseer has lost sight of them. Now they are coming into the back line. Earthmaster going to split up these Dark Templars, and one of them appears to be going back for this hatchery. Another one is sitting in here. I guess it's just going to wait, maybe until these Zerglings leave, and then attack. That's exactly what Earthmaster's going to know. He's going to go back in the main and try and finish off the hatchery with the Overseer being pulled away from this Dark Templar over here. Beautiful play right there. Did you guys see that? He's using this Dark Templar in the bottom right to pull the Overseer away and then brings the other DT up to kill that hatchery. Nicely done. I keep thinking I might be missing another DT warping, but I don't think so. As this DT is still alive here and now bringing up his main army. Actually, it looks like he warped in a couple of DTs just to make an Archon inside this army. And this is an extremely powerful army. This hatchery being destroyed means Blue Meanie is pretty much useless, at least for a while. And now Killaman is going to be trying to engage this straight up with Zerglings. That is not going to work. The bottom team, I don't know, man, going all in with Zerglings at the beginning. They did kill two players, but they let Earthmaster get extremely powerful. And I keep thinking there's going to be more DTs being warped in. It looks like, okay, that pylon did get taken out. There's one DT over here. And I'm not sure where that DT is going. And going to be losing another proxy pylon, it looks like, to some roaches here. At the same time, trying to press up this ramp. Killaman, well aware of this attack. And here we go. So many zealots in the front line for Earthmaster. Going to be extremely powerful against all these Zerglings. So wise decision getting all these zealots. And obviously the Archon is extremely powerful at this point in the game. And some more zealots down here. This army is getting beefy, beefy. We are on 5 gateways, I believe, now for Earthmaster. And he does have that second expansion really starting to kick in. And he's got the Zerg team pinned down here. It looks like he's going to come back into Blue Meanie's base and destroy it again. That is my guess. And he even has Blink now on the Stalkers. Going to be chasing these roaches away. This Archon's got to be careful, though. He is about to die. Bye-bye, Archon. So while worrying about chasing these roaches, Earthmaster did lose the Archon there, but not too big of a deal. His army is still extremely powerful, and this base looks like it's going to be in a lot of trouble. The Zerglings, however, have gotten inside of Earthmaster's army and surrounded a bunch of the Zealots, and now the Stalkers are blinking away, and this Stalker not blinking away. And now a bunch of Zealots in here to clean up some of these Zerglings. And desperately, Blue Meanie trying to pump out roaches. You can see them popping out and instantly beginning to fight, which is something you want to remember to do if you're desperately trying to warp in units or morph in units on Zerg, and you want to take away your rally points so that they begin to fight immediately when they pop out. But it doesn't look like that is going to be enough. These roaches so low on hit points, getting covered now by some more Zerglings from Killaman. This could be kind of close. There's one Hydralisk in the back and one roach here in the front, but it looks like they are going to pull back as more and more Stalkers are on the way in for Earthmaster. He is going to be able to finish off the Zerg base, it looks like, and more DTs now are on the way down. We have built a new proxy pylon here, and Earthmaster is going to be trying to defend that with a Zealot at the same time as taking on all of this stuff. Going absolutely berserk right now, Earthmaster kicking some ass. Killaman forced to retreat with a couple Hydras and Zerglings here, and another DT is down here slicing away at this base. Sorry, not that bad. This base! And no DTs are up and over there, but there is a Spore Crawler, and we are going to get an Archon, it looks like. And move on to the next base. As I wonder if Chronic Gaming and... let's see, we do have... Chronic Gaming and Ice both have some serious APM going. Well, I should say, like... they have real APM, so they must be controlling some armies. You can see here, okay, now this army is being controlled by Chronic Gaming. And Rayman is going to be able to pick off that pylon here. And now this whole army, controlled by... remember here, controlled by Chronic Gaming, will be coming in the backside of Rayman's base. And oh, this spine crawler has undug himself, and it could be focused down, but it looks like going to be chasing after the roaches and Zerglings instead. Now the spine crawler finally getting back in here and getting rooted, and the Zerglings from Killaman coming in quite late. The Stalkers blinking over into the corner here and finishing off the roaches. Now a bunch of Hydras from Killaman are coming in the backside, stripping through the Zealots, and oh no, the Stalkers cannot engage this directly. The Hydra is way too powerful. However, that blink will allow them to escape. I believe the Hydra is using that creep to their full advantage to try and get some free shots, but they will not be able to catch up to the Stalkers. And that is going to be a huge problem for Killaman, is how slow these Hydras are off of the creep. And Rayman, though, still alive. He did manage to save Rayman's base, so it is still technically a 2-on-1, but Earthmaster is on 2 base and even researching a Psystorm now. So are we going to see some serious Psystorm pain rain down on those Hydralisks? That would be pretty sweet. But looks like for now, those DT and Stalkers are going to try and contain these Hydras. Look out, a ton of Hydras now on the field for Killaman. And he's got his Overseer to kill all the DTs, so finally we got that working for us. It looks like the Stalkers go in, just blink away and continue to harass, as if you can see Chronic Gaming controlling those, and he has nowhere to macro, so you might as well just keep harassing. And you see this Dark Templar down here being controlled by Ice will get cleaned up there. And so yeah, even though Ice actually has drones here, choosing instead to just give away his minerals and control Earthmaster's units, I believe that to be a wise decision. He chose wisely. As it takes so long to rebuild, though, I mean, maybe once they did grab the upper hand, they could have tried to rebuild Ice's base. But at this point, I think they just want to try and end it. Psystorm's coming down for these High Templars! And oh my god, they're melting the Hydralisk so fast. Bye-bye. That was like the quickest battle ever. Sorry, I just like that one caught me off guard there for a second. The High Templars just melting the Hydras. That was pretty sweet. And so now Killaman is totally screwed. Totally screwed. He's got 4 Hydras left. The cover of these High Templars Could we even be side storming some drones here? That would be sweet. Look at that huge ball of drones. Oh, the side storm goes down all over the drones. And we're gonna need some side storms back on these hydras. There it goes. And that looks like it's going to be all she wrote, ladies and gentlemen. A pretty nice comeback in this game, if I do say so myself. And something, I mean, just one thing to take away from this game, as you can see, more and more stalkers being warped in to seal the deal. Like I said, one thing to take away from this game, if your teammates died, man, especially if you're on Protoss, because you have the capability on Protoss to get sort of a death ball. You saw it for a while that there was an army that the whole, no one on the boss team really could engage with all those zealots and stalkers. And then using the DTs to hurt the opponent's economy, buy time, delegate responsibility amongst your teammates. And so, you know, if you're using Skype or something, just be like, dude, okay, you're dead. Here, share control. Here, you take control of this army, and here, I'll warp in some DTs, you take control of that army. It's not over till it's over, man. Except in this game, I believe it's over. Well, now it's over. As Rain Man has left the game, and looks like that is going to do it. And so, pretty exciting match right there on Monsoon. Thank you, Earthmaster, for sending me this game. Pleasure to cast, even taking this third base that I did not notice somehow. So, that is going to do it for me. This is Irie Starcraft, and peace out.